you know that we are dealing with the chapter fraction, okay, right? So before that, before this, we are learning the concept of equivalent fractions, okay? Equivalent fractions means the fraction which looks different but having same value. And how it is, we have learned that how to find equivalent fraction, that also we have learned by two ways, by using multiplication and by using division, right? So the practice 5.5 and 5.6, which were based on that, we have solved. After that, we have taken worksheets also on that. Now today, next concept in same sub concept, we can say sub concept in that concept, equivalent fraction. This concept we are going to learn, that is checking equivalency of fraction. Means what? If two fractions are given and the question is check whether they are equivalent fraction or not. Whether they are equivalent fraction or not. Means one example I'll give here. Suppose there is 3 upon 4 and another fraction is 12 upon 16. So the question is check whether these 3 upon 4 and 12 upon 16 are equivalent or not. Are they equivalent or not? That we are going to check. So how to check that? That we are going to learn today. There is one very easy trick to check. Either you can check in this way. See 3 and 12. 12, how to get 12? When we multiply 3 by 4. 3, 4 is 12. If you divide, if you have multiplied 3 by 4 and if you are by same number, if you are multiplying to 4, then if you are getting this 16, 4, 4 is 16. Yes, getting, that means they are equivalent. But this is possible, in this way it is possible for only small numbers. As they are small numbers, so it is possible to go by this way. But if there are bigger numbers, then it's not reasonable. It's not applicable, okay? Then which method we should apply so that we can check whether they are equivalent or not? We are going to use the method of cross product. Cross product means this way. The numerator of first fraction and denominator of second fraction will multiply. And denominator of first fraction and numerator of second fraction will multiply. Okay. So see now here 3 into 16. And 4 into 12. Now see, when we multiply this cross product, this way and this way, if this product of this and product of this is equal, then we can say that 3 upon 4 and 12 upon 16 are equivalent. If cross product of two fractions, given two fractions, are equal, then we can say these both fractions are equivalent. Okay, for that we have to do the cross product in this way. Now see here, 16 3s are 48 and 12 4s are also 48, right? So cross product of both the fractions are equal. 48 48 are equal, so they are, this 3 upon 4 and 12 upon 16 are equivalent. Okay, in this way we are going to check whether the given fractions are equivalent or not. Practice 5.7. Check whether the following fractions are equivalent or not. See the first example, 7 upon 8 and 28 upon 32. Do the cross product in this way. 7 into 32. Write here box. 8 into 28. Okay, 7 into 32, why box we are writing here? We have to write there equal or not equal. And 8 into 26. Understood cross product means what? 7 into 32 means numerator of first fraction and denominator of second fraction. 7 into 32. Then denominator of first fraction and numerator of second fraction, that is 8 into 28. Okay, let's multiply. 32 into 7, 7 into 14. 1 carry, 7 is a 21 and 1, 22. 224. box. 28 into 8 are 64, right? 4 will come down, 6 will be carried. 8 2s are 16 and 6 22, same value, 224. So when we multiply the numerator and denominator of both the fractions, that is cross product we have done, at that time we got same product, they are equal, product of this and product of this is equal. So 7 upon 8 and 28 upon 32 are equivalent. Okay. Understood how we have done? The next. Here also same, the fraction is 5 upon 9 and 35 upon 60. We have to check whether they are equivalent or not. And to check whether they are equivalent or not, we are going to use cross product method. 5 into 60, 9 into 35. So 5 into 60, box, 9 into 35. 5 zeros are 0, 5 6s are 30. 300, box. 35 into 9. 9 5s are 45, 4 carry, 5 came down, 9 3s are 27 and 4 31, 315. See here, when we have done the cross product, the product of both sides, here there is 300 and here there is 315. The products are not equal. Not equal means this way, not equal. Equal means this way, not equal means in this way, right? They are not equal, so 5 upon 9 and 35 upon 60 are not equivalent, because their cross products are not same. If their cross products are same, then they are equivalent. If their cross products are not same, then they are not equivalent. Okay, next. 3 upon 10 and 21 upon 70. Let's do the cross product. 3 into 70, box. 21 or 10 into 21. 3 zeros are 0 and 3 sevens are 21, box. 10 ones are 21, zeros are 0 and 21. 21 ones are 21, right? Understood? 21 tens are 210. So product, when we have done the cross product, product on the both sides are same, equal. So 3 upon 10 and 21 upon 70 are equivalent. Got it? Next. 7 upon 12, 45 upon 60. So you have to do the cross product. 7 into 12, 60, box. 12 into 45. 7 zeros are 0, 7 6s are 42. 45 into 12. 12 5s are 60. 6 carry. 12 4s are 48 and 6, 52. Sorry, 54. Okay? So 12 into 45, answer is 540. Are they equal? Are these both products equal? No. So they are not equal. So 7 upon 12 and 45 upon 60 are not equivalent. Okay? Next, 1 upon 3, fifth one example.
1/3 and 3/9. Let's do 1/9 cross product. 1 into 9 and 3 into 3. This way. Okay? So 9 ones are 9 and 3 threes are 9. They are equal. So 1/3 and 3/9 are equivalent. If cross products are equal, then only they are equivalent fraction. Okay? So in this way we can check if two fractions are given and they are asked to check whether they are equivalent or not. In this way we can check by doing the cross multiplication, cross finding the cross product. Okay? Understood this? So this first 5 examples we have taken from the practice 5.7. Remaining 3 examples you have to do by yourself for the practice. Okay? So thank you for today and have a nice day.